confirmed is that it is hosted on the web by CornellUniversityArchives.com, of which everyone can have access to. That is the medium that we
and
the
so scientists... Have you informed the Ghana Health Service about this?
No, I have not informed Ghana Health Services about this because it is academic work that when we do it, what you have to do is that you should be able to propagate your findings, and then when your findings catches attention of authorities, then you speak to them. That is how models that we could actually work.
Based on this model, are you able to calculate Ghana's case and determine whether we've reached peak status?
Based on this model, if you understand the theoretical understanding of the model itself, the answer will be yes. But the question is that what kind of data is Ghana Health Service actually also giving out? Because the data that you use for this particular kind of model has to do with what we call daily incidence data. But as we speak, we do not have daily incidence data from Ghana Health Service. We do have cumulative data from Ghana Health Service. So we pray, and then we know that Ghana Academy of Arts and Science are actually put up a team working with them. When they're able to give the incidence data hosted at the Ghana Health Services website, then we'll be able to use our models, evaluate the data that they'll be able to give it to us, and those specific answers, as we ask, could be answered from there.
So are you able to say, for instance, that Ghana has reached peak status when it comes to COVID-19?
Without incidence data, I cannot make that confirmation. Because when we say Ghana has reached peak, this is what it means. It means that your data from start will be increasing to a point. At that point, your incidence data becomes much more stable, means that the increment will be highly significant. Example, if your incidence is 20 today, it could be 20 tomorrow, or it could be 21 the next day, it could be 22 the next day, then it comes to 20 the next day, 19. So you see, the incidence daily data will increase to that point that we call the turning point plateau, then begins to decline as the days goes on. Now, the only way for me to be able to evaluate this is if you have access to the incidence data.
And talking about the incidence data, now you talk about how the Ghana Academy of Arts and Sciences has a team working with the Ghana Health Service. You're part of the team?
I am not part of the team of the Ghana Academy of Health, Ghana Academy of Arts and Sciences. But what we do is that I am part of my group. We I publish the work with my superiors also, so we share information.
And in the information sharing, you know for a fact that we do not have daily rates when it comes to COVID-19 infection rates.
That's the point. We don't have daily incidence number as we speak. The daily incidence number is not available. So once we're able to get that, we will be able to do the situation for Ghana holistically and come up with concrete answers.
So in effect, it is we cannot say that Ghana has reached peak when it comes to COVID-19. It's impossible to determine.
Because the data for the evaluation for that particular answer is not available.
So we are wrong when we say Ghana has reached COVID-19 peak infection.
It depends on who is speaking. For instance, you talk of the Ghana Health Service director, and I'm sure he has much more data as I have. So if
you just told us that data is not available.
Yes, that data has not been made available to us. You go to the website of Ghana Health Service, it is not there. That data is not there.
Okay.
Daily incidence data for Ghana is not there. Okay. But I don't know what Ghana Health Service, the director, what he has. He works with the team on the ground, and I think he might have much more inside information. But if you ask me of my model and of my perspective in modeling of COVID-19 as happens to all infectious diseases, without the incidence data, you cannot point up to peak.
So if without the incidence data, you cannot point out to peak, it means we probably might be rushing. But hold on a minute, because Dr. Michael Owusu,